Hey guys, K-Counter here. Welcome to a Tekken 7 guide. It's gonna be a very short guide on the basic mechanics of the game. Yeah, I got practice mode put up on an infinite stage. Okay, first of all, you gotta go through movement. Alright, in this game, of course it's a 3D game, so you got the sidestepping. All you have to do is step up or down. And then you got your normal back dash, forward dash. But there's a few other states that you can be in. You can crouch, and while you're lifting up, while you're getting up, letting go of crouch, you can do a while standing. Okay, all this will be highlighted in your move list. Alright, as you can see, there's a lot of items in the move list. My advice to you guys is to actually go through the whole thing, and you can find out what is what. And you can even see each item played out by the by the computer. So you see, this is Wild Rising Rocket Heel. Crouch, standing up, and boom. Right. So you got Wild Standing, and you got Wild Running. Wild Rising and Wild Running. Wild Running will have certain moves. Each character will have different moves, but going through the move list is the best thing that you can do. Alright. You have to be very careful about your stances, or what state you are in, because certain moves put you in a different state. Like for example, this move, not that move. This move puts me in a crouching mode, so I can only continue up with a crouching move like that. Right, so you have to go and check out and test out all your moves in your move list. Right, now we're moving on to the hits. Okay, so you got three different hits: high, mid, and a low. All right. Highs, you need to block as per normal, just move backwards. And then mids, you have to block high as well. You cannot block this low. Put him on crouching guard, right? So he's crouching right now. He gets hit by the mid. Alright, make sure you block it high. Then you have the lows. Of course, the low standard, all you have to do is be in crouching guard. Block lows. Alright, high moves will actually whiff on crouching people. So you can duck and punish them with a wall standing. So this is why we have a wall rising. Okay? Right, so you got to take note and also figure out which moves hit where. So you know what you have in your arsenal. Right. Next item is actually moves that do certain things. Okay, so in Tekken, you have a few different type of moves. So, for example, you have this. No, not that. You have this. He spins himself. The opponent spins, and you can actually continue the move. But not that. You have to launch him first. So, my character Lee has two launches. This, which is down forward 2, and then up forward 4. Both are launches. So, a sample combo will be something like this. Put him into a spinning set, and then end the combo. Okay, that didn't really go well, but... Okay, basic combo will be... And then end it. So, launches are very important. Find out all of your characters' launches, and especially launches and counter hit moves. And the frame data, because you need to know which moves are fast. From what I've checked, Lee, this launcher, is safe on block. So if he blocks it, he cannot really punish me. I might be wrong on that. You have to check the frame data. I'll leave a link onto this site called RB Norway. He has all the characters' frame data, which is a very good site. I suggest you open it up on a separate screen and play along in practice mode. Figure it out. Right? Okay, counter hits. In this game, counter hits can do different things. This move actually makes him juggable. If that's even a word. It's juggleable, yeah. Okay, but I've not practiced that yet. So to be able to do counter hits in the practice mode, you can actually set it within the game, sorry. Other settings, player attacks, counter hit, and set to counter hit. But I think the easier way is so that you can have flexibility. Just press all the four buttons at once and you have key charge. And this will make things counter hit. For example here. So you can continue on. But like I said, I've not practiced counter hit combos. So I cannot show you one. Alright, next tip is to practice the sample combos that is shown in each characters. Alright, the sample combos, okay, you can actually see it here. You can click it and you can see the sample combos. It gives you an idea on how to form combos within for your character. For example, sample combo 3, you can actually change up what is being done. Misstep and then just back punches, you can change it up. You can finish it in a different way, but you have to figure out for which characters, for different characters, the different enders. Alright, so practice this and after that, figure out all the stuff. Like, for me, my favorite combo that I always use is this. Not that. This, and then continue with the ender. Okay, it's a bit tough to do, but I'm used to doing it. This is the combo that I always use. And since this launcher is quite fast, even, I mean it's safe, so I'll be using that often. Alright, for all your moves, test it out whether it's a counter hit and figure out a way to combo into it. Alright, in Tekken, defense is very important, so by learning your moves, you know what you can punish with. But the best way to improve is actually to play. And if you are afraid of going online, you can actually go to the treasure mode. Yeah, that's my next tip. Practice in treasure mode. The characters there actually do proper combos and they are quite tough. And if you can get very high rank in treasure mode, you unlock stuff anyway, so why not? Right. Okay, another thing. You have two different throws here. Okay, if you're from Street Fighter like me, you would think that's, oh, there's only one set of throws. Okay, that, which is the, like a normal mini punch, mini kick. But doesn't work that way, alright? This game, you have two basic throws, 1 and 3, and 2 and 4. Okay, you can see the difference in how they, your character moves. As you can see, left hand is extended for 1 and 3. 2 and 4, right hand is extended. How do you break those throws? You actually press 1 or 2, correspondingly. To figure out which throws does what, you have to go and into practice mode, of course, and record. Can actually record the computer actions to repeat this certain action. So I'm going to record one quickly and I'm going to record throw. This is your 1-3 throw. Alright, so he's going to do that throw. I'm going to let him play that and I'm going to break it. See, I'm breaking it with 1. Again. Yeah, I'm mashing the button, of course. So if I record the other throw, we'll start recording it. Second throw, right? And I'm gonna play it. I'm gonna mash on 2, and I get escape the throw. So that's how you escape the throws. But to know every single throw in the game is a lot of work. But of course, the work pays off because you will know what is gonna happen to you. Alright, so basically to recap, just a few short tips. This is basically, I'm doing this video because I came from a Street Fighter background, and when I started playing this game I was like, what the hell, this is totally different. So to start out, choose a character, alright, go through the moves list and figure out what does what, then practice sample combos, alright. And remember the basic rules like high, mids, and lows. Okay, learn how to mix them up. Like what I like to do with an opponent is to do jabs, 1, then the mid, 1 and a mid. Of course not often, but 1 and a mid. Sometimes I get hit, I'll do that. And I'll just go to the low. Because from the low I can do, it's in a crouching stance, so I can do a wall rising. Right, so I hit them in the low, and if he blocks it, I'll just be in crouch and I'll be wall rising. So all this important to practice and get down on the mechanics. And of course, I forgot the one most important thing: movement. You gotta be quick with the movement. Right, there's a lot of different moves that they have, so all is being explained in the move list, and you can actually check out what they can do by pressing the move, right? But you have to be able to move quickly. One tip, this is called the backdash cancel. If you look at my input display, it's back, two backs and then down back. This is to cancel the backdash, and you can backdash quickly. So let's say I'm here, and I hit him, and I feel like, okay, I'm in danger, just gonna backdash. Okay, I'm not doing it well, but this is something you can practice on, and you can move back, forward, move back, forward, move back. That's not it. And you can get away to safety. Alright guys, that's it. Yeah, I might have missed out some of the stuff, but this is just a basic quick start guide. So again, I'm gonna go through it. Pick the character, go through the moves list, and find out what does what. And practice counter hits, so that you know what you can do in case of a counter hit. Then you can continue on to the combo and do a max punish damage. Alright, and figure out all the stances. Okay, stances is a bit more complicated, but for now, just know what each move does and practice them. Alright guys, K-Counter here signing out. Thanks for watching. Please do like and subscribe. There will be much more content. I'll try to do a more in-depth guide, but I know the time, but when it happens, I'll do it, alright? I'll see you guys.